because I don't pitch things that I don't truly believe in and that I'm very passionate about. And so I don't pitch a lot, but I also don't get told no a lot. Now, I still have to execute on it, right? I still have to make sure that whatever budget I'm asking for makes sense based on the project. I still got to go to a particular actor or director and say, would you do it? Like, it's not like, oh, Will Packer's on it. Everybody just signs up. No, I still got to have a good project. Got to come in. I got to pitch it.
Saw the pilot for Bigger, which is really funny. Bigger, a series that you have on BET Plus. Yeah. Very funny. And you have that. You also have, you know, a ton of other things. You have a, was it Fight Night, right?
Yes.
Also some Fight Night, also something that you're working on, which is a podcast, correct?
It's a podcast. It's playing on iHeart right now. It's crazy. It's the true story of the biggest heist in Georgia history, which actually happened after an Ali fight. This was when Ali couldn't get sanctioned. He had been banned by all the major boxing organizations. So he went where everybody goes once you get banned, which is Atlanta, the ATL. He went down to Atlanta and fought a fight there unsanctioned. And you had all the biggest, you know, rich people. I don't care if they were drug dealers and dope boys or, like, you know, financial people. It didn't matter. Everybody came down, celebrities, entertainment, everybody came down. The biggest party after the fight was this casino night. And some dudes came in, stripped everybody butt naked and stole all their jewelry and furs and money after the fight. So it's still, it is the actual true story that Uptown Saturday Night, if you know that, I know you know that movie, but yep. Some people may know that movie with Bill Cosby.
With Bill Cosby and Sidney Poitier, yeah.
It is the actual true story that was based on. So we did a podcast and it's airing now. It is an incredible story. It really, really is.
Yeah, no, that sounds super incredible, especially the true crime genre, so big in podcasting. What's up on Girls Trip 2?
Girls Trip 2, man, listen. Have you had any of the girls on here? Have you interviewed them?
I have not.
We gotta get them on here. Here's the thing. Everybody is busy. Like, I want to do it and they want to do it. And first of all, we gotta crack the story, right? So Tracy Oliver, amazing sister who wrote the original along with Kenya Barris, like, they're great, working on some ideas. So I gotta get the right idea. I gotta get the right window to get the squad back together, right? Because Tiffany, Latifah, Jada, Regina, nobody's sitting around. They all, like,
right.
You know.
They booked it busy. All the
they
time.
Booked it busy. Right. And the other thing, Jay, is that, like, I don't want to do the sequel and everybody goes, why'd you mess it up, right? So it's got to be right. Like, if I'm going to do Girls Trip 2, it really got to be right. But we are working on it behind the scenes. I will tell you that. Stuff is happening. It just hasn't happened yet. And I think it'll be right. You know what I mean? Like, I don't mind that it's a little bit of time in between because I think it makes you miss those characters more.
Yeah. Well, with Think Like a Man, you've obviously proven that you can, you know, pull off, right? A sequel. Yeah. So, yeah, I think there's no worry there.
Yeah.
Now, despite, I mean, with all your success, when you go in to try to pitch a movie, is it still an uphill battle for you?
It's still a battle, but it's a different battle. Right. So I am now, Hollywood is all about the money, the economic validation of creators like me. So I now have a track record that I don't have to walk into a room and say, why should you do a project with me or why should you give me a budget? I've moved past that point. It doesn't mean that I always get everything I ask for. I still have to go in and say, this is what I want to do. But I definitely am in a position where it is much more likely, because I don't pitch things that I don't truly believe in and that I'm very passionate about. And so I don't pitch a lot, but I also don't get told no a lot. Now, I still have to execute on it, right? I still have to make sure that whatever budget I'm asking for makes sense based on the project. I still got to go to a particular actor or director and say, would you do it? Like, it's not like, oh, Will Packer's on it. Everybody just signs up. No, I still got to have a good project. Got to come in. I got to pitch it. But yeah, I get all my calls returned. You know what I mean? I get serious consideration and probably, you know, people are more likely to green light my projects for sure. So I'm very blessed in that aspect. I've earned it, you know, worked from the ground up, knew nobody in Hollywood, and have gotten to a point where I definitely consider myself a player in the industry. So I would never say easy, right? Because making any movie is hard, but I would definitely say I'm in a position now where a preponderance of projects that I'm bringing to the table are getting made. That's what I would say.
Yeah, we have, Ava DuVernay, Ryan Coogler. They both got 3-digit budgets. And by 3 digits, I mean in the hundreds of millions.
Yes.
You get an unlimited budget. What's the movie you're making?
Oh, sci-fi. I'm going to do a cool, because I'm a sci-fi fan and I haven't had a chance to make it yet. I'm going to do a sci-fi movie, you know, some dope Black people in outer space, not just Black, right? You know what I'm saying? I got 100 mil, so I got to put everybody in that one. But, you know, I would do some cool sci-fi. I'm actually looking at some projects right now in that vein. I have a project that is called Warrior Queen, and it's a true story of Queen Amarenas, who actually ruled as a woman, big deal back then. As a woman, she ruled the kingdom of Kush, what we think of as Egypt. She ruled that kingdom, and she had one eye. So she had this patch, and her army rode elephants, right? So they were bad. So imagine this bad sister with an eye patch on the back of an elephant. And this is when the Roman Empire was conquering everywhere, where there was one land that they could not conquer and they had to make peace with. And that was this kingdom, true story, that Queen Amarenas ruled. She ruled because her husband had been murdered, and then she got put into that position. They call her a Kandake, K-A-N-D-A-K-E. I may not be pronounced that right, but that's what they call those queens back in the day. And so she ruled it, and her story is amazing. So I see that as an expensive movie. It's set up at Universal. We're working on it now. Got somebody big that's going to star in it that I'll come back here and tell you.
All right, let me know.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh shit, we're about to make the Black 300.
Yeah. You got the right, there you go. See, it's like that. Right. 300, yep. Gladiator, like it's got Gladiator. That kind of energy, that kind of vibe.
All right, I'm with it.
Yeah.